Alma, women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the word is made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Pray for us, our Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain with us always, and may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation, set free from slavery, may render your majesty's service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
And created a place for us in the kingdom. before anything was created, he existed. And he holds all things in unity. Now, the church is his body. He is its head, as he is at the beginning. He was the first to be born from the dead, so that he should be first in every way, because God wanted all perfection to be found in him, and all things to be reconciled through him and for him. Everything in heaven and everything on earth, when he made peace by his death on the cross. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Stayed there before the cross watching Jesus. As for the believers, they cheered. He saved others, they said. Let him save himself if he is the Christ of God, the chosen one. The soldiers mocked him too, and when they approached to offer him vinegar, they said, "If you are king of the Jews, save yourself." Above him there was an inscription, "This is the king of the Jews." Celebration of the reign of our Lord Jesus Christ, King of the universe. ironic then that the Gospel reading today, which ends our church's year, is not an image of the glorified King of the universe, but the image of the King on the cross. The climactic moment of his time on earth, where he changes everything by his suffering and death. The sarcastically penned comment on the sign above the cross, "This is the King of the Jews," turns into the most truthful ban after all. And after that death, the doors of heaven are opened, making it possible for us to be saved and redeemed, just as the spirit was saved simply by believing in the reality of Christ as King, when Jesus said to him, "Today you will be with me in paradise." So Jesus' idea of King and power is totally opposite to the world's idea of a king and power. The people in those days of Jesus' time expected someone who was going to save them from the tyranny of the Roman Empire. Someone who was going to come with a great army and overcome their oppressors. Instead, how did he come? How did he come to take possession of his kingdom? How did he become the ultimate authority with power over nations? Certainly not the way they expected. He was born in a poor little village called Bethlehem. He was born in a stable made only for animal shelter. He lived simply. He lived purely. He lived graciously as he went among the people. And they hardly knew that Jesus, the Messiah, was with them. On many occasions, he told them not to tell others what he had done. They didn't recognize him because they were looking for a king of power and strength who would take vengeance on those who they felt had hurt them. They didn't expect a man who would take as his throne the cross and take as his crown a crown of thorns, and who would be meek and humble. But in the very end, a man who gave his very life for them, and that they would finally come to recognize the true King. The only authority that God has created, the only all worthwhile authority, is the authority of love. And the only way to express love is by giving and not taking. Through our baptism, we share Christ's kingship. As members of his body of the church, we are part of that kingship. And with it comes responsibilities. That place in Christ's kingdom that St. Paul speaks about is not a given. It has to be earned. Our Lord himself tells us that he will return as king when he's talking to his disciples. The Gospel of year 8 of his feast day, Matthew chapter 25, tells us that when the Son of Man comes in glory, escorted by all the angels, then he will take his seat on his throne of glory. That's Jesus speaking. Then the King will say to those on his right hand, "Come, you whom my Father has blessed, take your heritage, the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you made me welcome. Naked, and you clothed me. Sick, and you visited me. In prison, and you came to see me." And we know said this about Jesus. He must reign in our hearts, he must reign in our minds, and he must reign in our words. So today, as we celebrate the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ, King of the universe, let us all open our hearts and minds to him. Let us allow him to rule our hearts and minds so that we might honor him. Let us mock ourselves on Christ the servant King. Today is a joyful celebration because Jesus is not like a king of earthly kingdoms who may be remote from their people. Jesus is close to us. He walks by our side. He lifts us up when we need help. He gave his life for us. Our celebration of Jesus Christ as King today means that we need to place Jesus first in our lives at all times. We need to let Jesus reign in our minds by blocking out voices such as those from the internet and media that are contrary to Jesus' teaching. Instead, fill our minds with what would please him. When we let Jesus reign in our minds, it's much easier to let Jesus reign in our hearts. And when we let Jesus reign in our hearts and minds, it is then that we do the things and make the decisions in life that Jesus would want us to make. It is then, and only then, that we will serve others as he served and serves us. It is then, and only then, that we will learn our place in his kingdom.
I believe in one of all the Lord Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, for our sin and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. Our Savior was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and raised again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life. We proceed from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, God has taken us out of darkness and created a place for us in the kingdom of the Son he loves, and so we pray.
For the Church, called to continue the mission of Christ. May all members of Christ's body bring about a kingdom of holiness and grace. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For world leaders working to bring about the common good of all people. May they bring about a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For our young people and the parish community who encourage them. May they all strive to be worthy of a kingdom of truth and life. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For the sick and housebound, and all those who are homeless. all that quickly departed, passing over from death into life. May they now take their place in the kingdom of refreshment, light, and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our
prayer. May our Lady, the Queen Mother, pray for us and with us as we say.
Almighty Father, your Son has made peace by his death on the cross, and so we ask you to hear and answer our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May your Lord accept our
sacrifice. As we offer you, Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is just and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you united your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness, as eternal priest and king of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross, as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom. A kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love and peace. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
Spirit of Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance from your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, of whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
For all heaven and earth and heaven, all the mighty Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by my teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from evil, graciously grant peace in our days. That by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, and live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other
Let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, a glory and obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, who may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Now, please be seated. So just to remind you that we're 2 weeks away from the Christmas market after the night of Mass on Sunday, the 4th of December. So along with the collection for the food bank, there's extensive refreshments, a good number of stalls, raffles, tombolas, tickets, books, toys, items which are still being collected, which you can leave in the back in the porch, and proves to be a good social event as well. There are a limited number of printed newsletters available which are intended only for those who do not have access to the online newsletter at the parish website. Today's second collection is for Arundel Cathedral maintenance. We have an obligation to maintain the Mother Church of our diocese. It's the 150th anniversary next year of the cathedral, so we would all hopefully get a chance to visit at some point. You know, as always, you'll find the first and the second collection boxes on the way out to church, just parallel on the line there with St. Anson's statue. Jermaine is going to give us a very brief reminder about the lay apostolate of adoration, which is being really encouraged across the diocese.
Good evening. So I'm here to speak of how adoration is an important support in letting our light shine, our imagination. As Catholics, we believe in Jesus' real presence in the Blessed Sacrament, genuflecting on entering the church, and when we pass the tabernacle. At the consecration, the bread we offer becomes Christ's body. As our Mass, the host is placed in monstrance, and in adoration, this moment is extended. At present, our parish adoration on Fridays after 10 a.m. Mass, and will now on Friday evenings at 7:15 p.m., as well as after Mass on Saturday morning, and before the Vigil Mass on Sunday, off Sunday. Of course, we can spend time with Jesus at home, but there's a unique closeness when we spend time before him in the Blessed Sacrament, to be his presence and talk to him about what is happening in our lives. It is a place together without all the distractions of home and work. Adoration sends our belief in the real presence of Jesus. We invite us to come and see, always wishing to increase our faith in him as the way, the truth, and the life. As a parish group, we establish our new parish mission to help each parishioner let the light shine. And adoration is an integral part of this, as it allows the Blessed Sacrament to shine upon our parish, bless our community, and our time. Adoration of the Blessed Sacrament helps parents teach their children about the real presence of Christ, beginning with a short period, building up a sense of reverence for the Blessed Sacrament, especially as we prepare for Holy Communion for the first time and each Sunday. Adoration of the Blessed Sacrament is a key part of the lay apostolate. And so, on Friday evenings, we're looking to build out the adoration team so that the Blessed Sacrament can be exposed securely and never be left unattended. This team is to include an additional extraordinary minister of Holy Communion who can cover me in my absence. We will also need more adorers, so that the light of Jesus can shine more brightly. In the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus asked his disciples, "Could you not keep watch with me for 1 hour? direction we can seek in silence, looking at him, contemplating his question to the blind beggar. What do you want me to do for you? We can read the Bible, immersing ourselves in scriptures, talking to Jesus in our hearts, sharing with him our hopes and fears, and listening to his response. We can pray for people's intentions, our family, friends, and the needs of the world. And we can pray for the intentions that others have left for us. For this purpose, we have come after this mass, and I can be able to put them at the back. We will have some boxes with cards available. So you can have them in one of the first boxes at the back of the church here. You can put your intention card, so fill it. You don't have to put your name. If you want to put your name, that's fine. If you don't, you will put it then in the box, which we say, to be prayed for. And we will encourage the doors to then come before they come for the Blessed Sacrament. Take some of the cards, take them and pray for them, and then add them back in the box which is prayed for. So I will be at the back of the church if you have any questions. Thank you.
Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.